specifically to our body. Yadannam dehadhatu ojo belavarnadi poshaka tatra agni hedu aharat nahi abakvat rasadayah. You know, anna under the normal influence of normal agni, it will be changed into dadu ojas bela varna, isn't it? And that function is done by the agni. Agni is the hedu for the parinama of anna into deha dadu, means the nutrient materials that are suitable for the body. Deha dadu, dadus will eventually turn into ojas, and that is needed for the normal bela as well as varna. So that agni or that ushma factor which helps in the parinama of anna into poshaka factor is agni. Got it? And aharat nahi apakvat rasadya. If the ahara is not being properly paka, nahi abakvat, if it is abakva, what will happen? Rasadaya will not be formed. Rasadaya means rasarektadi dadus will not be formed. This can be considered as a specific action of agni to our body. Got it? This is also important. Now, let's see how the doshas and agni are related. Samana Vayu and Agni. Now let me ask you, this is very interesting. Okay, where is the location of Samana Vayu? Samano Agni Samibaste, isn't it? Koshte Jaratihi Sarvadaha. Where is our Samana Vayu located? Samana Vayu is located in the Koshta Agni Samibaste. Just remember Agni Samibaste, okay? And where is the Stana of Agni? Agni, in the Grahaniya Adhyaya, it is said that Pakva Amashaya Madhyaka. To be more specific, Agni, according to Aruna Datta commentary, he says that it is Grahani Stasya. Agni is located in the Grahani or Pakku Amashe Madhyaka. Now, did you understand how Samana Vayu and Agni is related? Both are having the sthana is same. Okay? Sama Samane Sthanaste. That is, when the Samana Vayu is in its normal sthana. The first Sama means normal sthana. Okay. It is called as Samagni. Vishamo Agni Vimargake. If the Samana Vayu is moving out from its sthana, that is Vimarga Gamana happens, that will lead to Vishama Agni. Pittavir Murchite Tekshno. When the Samana Vayu is involving with Pitta, vitiated Pitta, that will lead to Tekshna Agni. And Mando Asmin Kapapedite. If it is being coming in contact with vitiated kapha, it will lead to mandagni. Okay, this is the in the later slides I will tell you the four stages of agni or the four types of agni drushti, and this is the reason why these three types happen. Okay, samano deepyati agnim agnehe sandukshago hisa. Samana vayu, I told you, where is it located? Samano agni samibasta, isn't it? It is located near to agni. So what is the function of there? Just like when you, in the olden days, when you are boiling something in a pot, in the olden days, we used to blow air from the sides, isn't it? The same way, the same action is happening in the case of Samana Vayu. It is situated near to the sides of agni for the Deepyati Agni, for the enhancement of Agni. And that is why in Agni Mandya conditions, Krida processed with the Padu and Shundi is given. We will discuss that in later. This is, I have already told you, Samana Vayu is responsible for the Palana, because Samana Vayu, the location is Agni Parshvastidena. As you can see in the picture, if a pot is boiling and just below is the Agni, in order to Agni to be kept intact or for Palana, the Samana Vayu is helping it. Agni Parshvastidena, Agni is, Samana is located on the Parshva of Agni, Samanena Sandukshidaha. And again, Prana and Apana Vayu are also having the role. Prana, Anna Adanam, it brings food to the Koshta. In simple terms, Prana Vayu helps in bringing the substances to the sthana of Agni through Srotas. Did you understand? Pranavayu helps in bringing the substance, whatever may be the substance. Here it is Anna. Pranavayu brings the Anna to the sthana of Agni. Where is the sthana of Agni? Koshta or Grahani. Whereas after the Parinama, the waste material or the Kitta portion is being expelled through the Srodasas with the help of which Vayu there? Apana Vayu. Got it? That is how Prana and Apana Vayu is responsible for Agni Dhmabana, initiation of Agni, whereas Samana Vayu helps in the Palana. So, in nutshell, we can say that if the Prana, Apana and Samana Vayu are normal, what will be normal? Agni will be normal. But if any vishesham happens to these three Vayu, what will happen? Agni Dushti will be the result. Got it? Now, that was about the Vata Dosha and Agni. Now, coming to Pitta and Agni. Let me ask you, are they same or are they different? Well, we just listen. Okay. Agni manifests its power through Pitta Dosha. Did you understand anything? Agni manifests its power through Pitta Dosha. Now, I told you in the first slide while explaining the Nirupti, Agni, what was the Nirupti? Nayade Parinamyade, isn't it? That Ushma factor which is responsible, that heat which is responsible for the Parinama, we call it as Agni. So, for the Agni to act on the body, what does it need? It needs certain qualities, isn't it? It needs the Ushna quality. And that quality is imparted with the help of Pitta Dosha. That is why in many of the contexts, we call Pitta synonymous as Anala or Agni itself. Okay? Ushna of Pitta. Pitta is also having Ushna Guna. And that Ushna is doing the Pajati or Dahana Pajana. That is why it is also, Pitta is also known as Andaragni. Pitta is also known as Andaragni because the Ushna of Guna of Pitta will do the Dahana Pajana. And where is the Pitta Sthana again? Agni Sthana is Grahani, Pakvamashe Madhya. Pitta Sthana is also Pakvamashe Madhya, where the Pajana is happening. And that is why it is known as Pajaka Agni. Pajaka Pitta is otherwise called as Pajaka Agni because of the Sthana. Now, again, Pajaka Pitta does the Pajana function, isn't it? Pajati Annam Vipajate Sarakitam. It is the Pajaka Pitta that is doing the Pajana of Anna into two products, Sara and Kitta. And hence, it is called Anala. Anala is nothing but Agni. You understood why Pitta is called Agni? Both are interrelated in this context. Panjafudatmakatve abhi yat tejasa gunodayat Tyaktadravatvam bhagadi karmana anala shaktita. This is the reference or the quotation for which Pitta? Pajaka Pitta, isn't it? It is the definition for Pajaka Pitta. Why? Even though it is predominantly made up of Panjamahabhudas, because of the predominance of Tejasaguna and Tyaktadravatvam. Listen, what are the properties of Pitta? Pittam, Sasneham, Tishnoshnam, Laguvisram, Saram, Dravam. Dravam is the property of Pitta, but Agni, it is Tyakta Dravatva. It doesn't have the property of Gati or movement, isn't it? But Pagadi, it does the function of Paga, and that is why Pajaka Pitta is called as Anala. Got it? Now, let's see why, how Pitta and Agni differs. Agni does Pajana with the help of Samana Vayu. In other words, we can say that Agni does Pajana alone with the help of Samana Vayu. But what are the functions of Pitta? It imparts Rasa, Gandha, Varna, Gadi along with Pajana. Okay? So in nutshell, we can say that the chemical transformation, that is the conversion of Anna into Sara and Kitta, is by Agni. Whereas the physical transformation is by Pitta. That is the conversion of that Sara part into the various Rasagandha Varna is done by the Pitta. Physical transformation is by Pitta. And again, Pitta Dushti can affect any organ anywhere, isn't it? It can affect all the organs. But Agni Dushti has only four states in general, isn't it? Four states, one is the Samavastha and the other is the three Vigradavastha. Manda, Tishna and Vishrama stage. You got it? These are the minute differences between Pitta and Agni. But the main concept is that the Ushna Guna or the Ushma Guna imparted in our body is Agni. Now let's move on to the types. How many types are there? There are 13 types of Agni. Jadar Agni, which is the Adipa of all Agni.